Phoenix, Arizona is an amazing place to live, but that does not mean that it's gonna be the right fit for everyone. So on this video, I'm gonna cover the top 6 reasons why Phoenix, Arizona might not be the right fit for you. So if you're thinking about moving to Phoenix and you wanna make sure that it is the right fit for you, let's go. Hey everyone, this is Camilo Quevedo with eXp Realty. I'm a real estate agent here in the Phoenix metro area. If you want to know what is life in the Phoenix metro area and the West Valley here in Arizona, make sure that you hit subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified weekly as I create these videos, letting you know what life in Phoenix, Arizona and the West Valley is like. Now, I have received hundreds of calls from clients that have helped move here to Phoenix, Arizona. So if you're thinking about moving, make sure that you give me a call, send me a text, shoot me an email, let me know so I can make sure that you end up in the right place, in the right location that fits your needs and the needs of your family. So let's get started. I'm gonna be as generic as I can so it covers every city in the Phoenix metro area. So whether you're in the West Valley, in Surprise, Peoria, or Glendale, whether you're in the East, on Mesa, Gilbert, Scottsdale, or you're in the actual city of Phoenix, these are gonna apply to you if you end up living here. So let's go with the first one, and it's the one that everybody knows about, and it's the one that's everybody's mind, the weather. Yes, it is extremely hot here during the summer. We have to deal with everyday temperatures of 105 to 115, 17 on a regular basis. Now, this is going to affect two kinds of people the most. First, if you just can't get over how hot it is. And this is what I mean. There's people that live here that every day are surprised by how hot it is. They go outside like, my gosh, it's so hot. Why is it so hot? And they keep trying to answer why is it so hot versus it's hot. Deal with it. Move on. Live the rest of your life. Adjust to it. So you feel like you're gonna be fighting constantly against the weather, this might not be the best place for you. The other reason why the weather or the heat of the summer might affect you is because it forces you inside. Being outside is not an option, especially if you have younger ones. If you have kids, they can be outside for 5-10 minutes at the most, and then you have to bring them inside to make sure that they don't have a heat stroke, they don't have dehydration, they're not overheated. So if you have kids, this is definitely going to apply to you even more, which means you're going to spend a lot of time indoors. Now, some of us like the outdoors. Some of us get energized by sun on us, by the fresh air, by nature. So if this is you, you really cannot stand being indoors. You really have to stop and think about, hey, I'm going to be spending 3 months out of the year indoors. On air conditioner spaces, whether it's your home, whether you go to stores or the mall or to indoor playgrounds, you're always going to be indoors. So for me personally, I don't care about the heat. I lived in Vegas before, I've played golf at 120 degree weather. I'm okay with the heat. I move on, that's it. Being indoors though, that is really something that affects me. I have to be outside and I do my best to try to wake up as early as I can so I go out before the sun goes out, and even then it's still extremely hot, but at least I get my outside time around the 5 in the morning time or so, which is the only time that I can be outside. So I make it work, but if that's something that you, that being outside and that's something important to you, you have to consider there are gonna be 3 months of the year where you're gonna be inside. So reason number two, it's gonna be there is no seasons here. So yes, you are going to have cold weather, beautiful weather, and a little bit of a cold, hot weather, but there's really no changing seasons. So if you come from a place where you love the big green trees and grass and how it changes colors and how you go from summer to winter, now there's snow, and there's this constant changing of seasons, you are not going to experience that here in Arizona. It's pretty much exactly the same. It's completely blue sky, scorching hot sun, and just the only thing that changes is how hot you actually are. So whether you go outside and feel 115 degree weather, or you go outside and you feel a cool 65 or 60 in the winter, it's going to look exactly the same. It's just the temperature is going to be different. So if you're somebody that likes to see the trees and changing and having that experience, is definitely not going to be much of that there. Reason number three, we live in the desert, which means there are going to be critters, there's going to be bugs, there's going to be wildlife. And this is something that you're going to have to deal with, especially if you live a little bit on the outskirts of Phoenix or you live in a single family home. Obviously, if you live in an apartment building, in a condo, something like that, you might not have to deal with wildlife or critters or bugs as much. But if you live on ground level, you are going to deal with this. There's a lot of bugs, there's a lot of ants, scorpions. Right now, there's a lot of grasshoppers, or I'm assuming it's grasshoppers that look like grasshoppers. There's a lot of, at least in my house, I found like unidentified bugs that I have no idea what they are. So there's something that you just have to keep a mind out. Right now, I actually have an ant hill right on my backyard, on my grass. So today is actually where the bug people come in. And I'm gonna ask them to go and try to treat it so I can actually step on the grass without being flooded with ants. So it is something that you're gonna have to deal with. Yes, there is gonna be pest control. I have mine come once a month, they spray the house. So I very rarely find any bugs inside of the house. And I usually do if I leave the door open, bring the groceries in for a long time or at night. When I'm trying to carry my girls into the house after a long day and they're falling asleep. So I have to pop the door open and just carry them in. And that takes a 10-minute process where the door is open, lights are on, cool air is coming out, and all the bugs are just happy to come and take a visit. So in those cases, I'll have the occasional grasshopper come into the house, or cricket. I think it's crickets, not grasshopper, crickets. That's the word I was looking for. Crickets come into the house, there's some moths. This season particularly, just because monsoon was so wet, there was a lot of mosquitoes during the summer. So we had to deal with mosquitoes, which my daughter has this, every time she gets bit, has like these huge big welts that just become blisters. So that was something that we have to just pretty much keep her inside most of the time, because if we go outside within 10 minutes, we will have 10 bites. And for me, I don't care. I just scratch them away and tomorrow they're gone. But my daughter gets like really bad reactions to any mosquito bite. So we had to keep that in mind. So bugs is something that you're just gonna have to deal with. When it comes to, like I said, inside of the house, unless you like to leave the doors open and just invite the critters in, then you might get a couple of them. But with a good pest control company, you're going to be able to put them on check. Scorpions, I have not seen any. And I hope that I keep it that way. Although people here have told me that I just have to grab a black light and go out at night. And then they are going to be able to see them. They said that they're like this big, the ones that you see around most often. So you're not going to see like the big movie style scorpion that is going to come and attack you. But there's like little things here. Apparently they're like white, and with a black light at night, you can see them. You can go and just go scorpion hunting, which is actually something that people do here. So you're going to have to find a way to deal with that, to be able to be here and just have a peace of mind about being here. Now, if I'm forgetting something, I'm still learning and I'm still getting to be a part of this community and learning all the ins and outs of it. So if you know of something that I should have mentioned that people need to know about living here in Phoenix, make sure that you drop it there in the comments. I'm always regulating those, looking at those. So I'm always looking to learn something that I may have missed. And most importantly, if you can share it with everybody that's watching, even better. All right, so let's talk about the cost of living. Now, this one, I'm going to be honest with you. This one depends really where you're coming from. So if we have the way that it's calculated, the average city in America would be 100. Phoenix is at 103.7. So our cost of living is definitely above average. So depending on where you're coming from, you might see an increase on your cost of living. Now, what makes Phoenix cost of living so more expensive than most places is going to be transportation. there's really not much public transportation in Phoenix, and Phoenix is very spread out, so you're gonna have to travel quite a bit, pretty much no matter where you're at. So that makes transportation prices rise a lot. One thing that is actually low in Phoenix is health. Health insurance and health costs are actually lower than the national average. Now, I say that it depends because personally, this didn't affect me. I came from San Diego. San Diego on that index is at 160 plus. So cost of living in San Diego, 100 being average, is 160. So for me, I went from 160 to 103. I'll take it any day of the week. But again, we are above average, which means there's a lot of people that are gonna see an increase if they decide to move to Phoenix. Like I mentioned, I like the outdoors. So for me, number five is that there is no access to water. Now, I know that might be obvious. You're moving to the middle of this desert. You're moving to a state that has no border with oceans. But I came from San Diego. I love the water. I learned to surf. That's where I went to like meditate. That's where I went to recharge. That's where I took my daughters to have fun. So for me, water and the ocean just became something that I got accustomed to. There's a couple of man-made lakes around the cities here. So most cities will have some kind of man-made lake. They might have some fishing in there, but there's not really like a place to go and just be in the water. I mean, you can go north in Peoria to Lake Pleasant, where you can actually rent a boat or take your boat and do some jet skiing or play in the water itself. But it's not the same. That's not like a lot of places. Granted, San Diego is only 5 hours away. So it's not like I have to do something crazy. If I really miss it, I get to go and enjoy it over the weekend, which is actually something I'm gonna do here next month. Me and my wife are gonna go and enjoy San Diego here over the weekend. So it is still there. It's just a 5 hour drive there. Not too bad, but you don't have it here. It's not something you can do on a regular basis. And for me personally, again, that's something that I wish I had, but I don't. Being inland has its drawbacks as well. Number six is snowbirds. So they follow the bird pattern. So during the summer, they go up north where it's nice, and during the winter, they come on south where it's nice. Why do I bring the snowbirds into this conversation? Well, first of all, it's awesome to have people come from all over the place to join us here in Arizona. You get more diversity, you get to meet more people, things have more energy, things have more excitement just because there's more people here. Drawbacks of that, there's more traffic, there's more congestion, and things are more busy, are busier than they used to be. So why is this an issue, especially for people here? Just keep in mind, you've been for 4 months trapped because of the heat. And when you're ready, and during this time, there's nobody in the streets, everything's empty, everything's vacant just because there's like nobody's outside. You can't go outside. So as soon as you're ready to go, head back outside and start doing things, get out of there, all these extra people come in and make everything busier. So that's why snowbirds is one of those things that a lot of people here do not like. And when I say do not like, keep in mind, people here are extremely friendly. Even if you're from California and you're thinking about moving here, yes, you're gonna get your eyes rolled at you as soon as you say California. You're gonna get some comments about why Californians shouldn't be here or how this has changed because of Californians. And as soon as they get that out of your chest, then they're gonna say, hey, my name is blah, and then you're gonna move on with their lives and never bring that up again. So yes, you're gonna get those type of reactions, but for the most part, people here are incredibly friendly. And they're looking to make connections, they're looking to make friends, they're looking to welcome you here into the city. So even though, yes, there is some cons of having so much people come here during a specific period of time, you're still gonna be welcome here, you're still gonna be happy to have you here, and you're still gonna be make you part of the family and the community once you're here. Guys, as you can tell, there are reasons. This is not for everybody. And that's just Phoenix in general. Each city here has its own pros and cons. So if you're thinking about moving, make sure you give me a text. Give me a call. Shoot me an email. Let me know. Make sure that you end up on the right city that actually fits you. There's places here that are amazing. And people go there and they realize, yeah, this is not for me. So make sure that you reach out. Let me help you make sure that you end up in the right place of the city. And until next week, have a good day.